It is time to bow down and worship at the altar of the Irish sports star who has reached the absolute pinnacle of WWE. She's even replaced The Rock as the main event at WrestleMania. Let's have a little look at her in action. Not the face, not the face. She's one of the most successful wrestlers in the world, and for one night only, she is back here in her native Dublin. We are delighted to say, let's get ready to rumble with the man herself. It's Becky Lynch! There you go. The fans are in, Becky.
The man has come around to the Late Late Show.
The man is home.
Feels good to say that.
It does feel good to say that. I mean, we were just talking about this during the week in the office. I mean, your main event on WrestleMania, you've won the Royal Rumble. How does coming back and being on the Late Late Show? I know that your mum is slightly impressed with this, is she?
I think this means I've made it.
Oh,
this
wow.
means I've made it. To her, but also to myself, you know? This is one of those shows that I grew up watching, and to be able to sit here with you, it's fabulous.
And what's it like being back home for a couple of days and
That's
feeling a wee
great.
Bit of the love?
Well, I've only been back for a couple of hours. We were in Cardiff last night. I had a show in Cardiff last night, and tomorrow we're in Belfast. So
okay.
It's fantastic.
It's a flying visit.
It's a flying visit, but I get home, I get to stay at the mother's house. I'll get to drink a couple of cups of tea and have some toast. It'll be great.
Brilliant.
Yeah.
Going back to you as a teenager, Rebecca Quinn, staying up all night watching WWE on the TV. I mean, what's it like now, 20 years down the pipe, actually hanging out with some of these people that you were watching back then, The Rock, Stone Cold Steve Austin? I mean, what's that mean to you?
Yeah, it's wild because, so the person who got me into wrestling, one was my brother. My brother was the person who watched it, and he would have it on the TV, and I would walk past it, and I was the worst. I'd be like, don't you know that stuff's all fake? It's for babies. And he was like, no, it's really good. And there was one wrestler called Mick Foley who captivated me. He was amazing, and he had this particular way of talking, and he wrote his own book. And I decided when I wanted to be a wrestler, I wanted to write my own book. And he has become a very close friend, and he was able to help me with my book. And so the people that say, don't meet your heroes because you'll only be disappointed, well, their hero wasn't Mick Foley, because he spent like 6 hours on the phone with me several times going through my book line by line. And then The Rock has become like a mentor to me. And Stone Cold Steve Austin, if I have a question, I'll call him up on the phone. And it's like, what is this life? And then my favorite female wrestler, Lita, I got to have a match with her in Saudi Arabia, where only a few years ago, women weren't allowed to wrestle at all. So all of these things that are bucket list items that are just happening at a rapid pace, because we're on the road 52 weeks a year, so you almost don't get time to sit back and reflect.
To sit back and take it all
and
in.
And go, wow.
Until
I'm
you come here.
Until you come here.
And you sit down.
And now
down.
I sit down and I go, I'm on the Late Late Show. I made it. You know? It's pretty cool.
You know, you mentioned there when you were a kid, you thought wrestling was fake. From what I can see, the pain is real. How dangerous is it?
It's pretty dangerous, you know?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I think we got a little clip here.
Just look at my
oh, wow.
arms, you know, and this is just from a... Anyway, maybe the lighting's good. The lighting's good in here. You can't
no,
see
no. No, we're gonna have a little look here at you doing your stuff. I mean, this looks sore.
Climbing to the ladder Oh my God, Becky Lynch up on the top rungs here. Looking down at Asuka and Flair. Oh, through the table!
Sorry for them. Sorry for them. I was fine.
But I mean, that, even for you, that looks...
There's no way to fake it. There's no way to fake it. You can't fake gravity. A lot of the punches are real, unfortunately. But it is storytelling. And that's the thing that I love about it. It's an art, it's a craft, and it's finding the best ways to elicit an emotional response from the audience. And that's what we do.
And that's why it's so huge. I mean, for someone who's under a rock, tell us how big WWE is. Tell us what a big deal it is for you to have main evented WrestleMania.
Well, I mean, it's global, right? We're in over 170 countries worldwide. There's nothing like it. There's nothing like it because it's everything. It's athleticism, it's high stakes, there's drama, there's romance, there's comedy, and it's all happening live in front of an audience. And anything can go wrong at any moment, which is exciting and exhilarating and dangerous, obviously. And so there's so much of it to be engaged by. But so WrestleMania, in its history of, now we're at 40 years, but when I main evented, it was 35 years, and a woman had never main evented WrestleMania. Never, never. And it was to the point where it was seen as something that was probably just never going to happen. And I remember when I got signed to WWE, I told my friend, like, one day, you just watch, I'm going to main event WrestleMania. And he didn't mean this to be disrespectful, but he said, it's nice to have dreams, but be realistic. And as much of a gut shot as that sounded like, it wasn't. It was just kind of like, okay, well, watch me. And so
to go from someone like The Rock being the main event on that event to you, what was that feeling like?
It was right, you know? Damn right. Damn right I was going to be the main event. That's what I left home for. That's why I kept my mouth up at nights worrying. It felt right. And the thing was that I didn't want to be the main event because of a token gesture of okay, now it's 35 years, it's time for the women to be the main event. I was the main event because people were behind me, because they were invested in the story that I was telling, and they wanted to see me win. And I won. Becky Two Belts, walked out of there with two titles on my arm.
You're talking to Two Belts there. Your husband is also a wrestler.
He is, yeah. He's great.
Let's have a little look at this handsome devil. There he is. Oh. There he is.
Sweet swoo. Yeah. Me too. Yeah.
And you've also got a wee girl called Rue.
Yeah, a little three-year-old. What?
She's three?
Yeah.
So how do you guys do the juggle with being on the road?
So he just got surgery on Tuesday. So he had knee surgery. He tore his meniscus a little while before WrestleMania. And so his rehab, I suppose, is running after a little three-year-old now. That'll be great for his knee surgery. But normally we travel with her. We're very lucky. We have a tour bus, and so we wouldn't be able to do it without it, because we're on the road 4 days a week in different towns every night all over the place, and she comes with us.
Is it a career that you'd recommend to her?
The thing is that if she wanted to do it now, of course, because there's no limits on what you can do as a woman in the sport. Your ma's the main event, you know?
You're talking
about... And so is her dad!
And so is her dad.
But, like...
Your mum maybe wasn't as keen for you to go into the wrestling, and you followed her into another job for a little bit.
I did.
Tell us about that.
I was a flight attendant, an air hostess, for Aer Lingus.
For Aer Lingus.
For Aer Lingus, yeah.
Nobody's messing with this one on a stag weekend, Amsterdam. The exits are here. Wow.
Busted out of a few uniforms.
And how long did that last?
Two and a half years.
But it was actually your dad, wasn't it, who kind of told you to follow your dreams?
Yeah, so, like, I liked the fly-in, but it wasn't for me. It wasn't for, there was always that something in the back of my head that, you know, well, there was always a pull for wrestling. Because I left wrestling when I was 19. In some ways, I felt like I was too old, you know? Like, I needed to grow up and be realistic at 19, which is wild. And I left it for... Then I became the flight attendant. And I was like, no, the thing that I loved about wrestling was the performance. So I went back to college and I studied acting. And then when I was done with acting, I blagged my way onto the set of The Vikings. Because
as you do?
Yeah. I was trying to get an acting role, but they looked at my CV and was like, oh, well, this is a stunt person. So then they called me, were like, do you do stunts? And I was like, yeah. Of course I do. That's what I do. And so when I got the call, then I was like, I don't know what I'm doing. I don't know. But I was good at wrestling. So if I go down to wrestling school and then get the confidence from that and then apply it to the stunts, then nobody's going to be any the wiser. And so I went down to the wrestling school and my friend Joe was teaching the class and he had just gotten signed to NXT, which is WWE's developmental brand. And he was like, would you go for a tryout? Because I think you'd get it. And I was like, no, I'm doing my acting thing. I'm doing my stunt thing, apparently. And I just thought about it for 2 seconds and it was like, oh, away we go, off to the races. This is what I'm meant to do. And then I got back into it and my dad loved it. And actually my mom was really supportive at that stage because when I was watching as a teenager, you have to understand that it wasn't the most savory of sports for women. It was all bra and panties matches and mud wrestling matches and pillow fighting. And there was nothing that I could point to and say, no, that's not what I want to do. I want to do what I'm doing now.
It's what you're doing now. And you went from being that teenager with a dream. You followed that dream. You are right at the top of your game. We are so delighted. We are so proud of you. And we are so happy that you've made just a wee bit of time to come and see us tonight. Give it up one more time for Becky Lynch.
Thanks so much for having me. I appreciate it.